Shalom, Yashirela, Shalom. Brakat Yahweh, Brakat Yahweh Shay. Brakat Yahweh, Brakat Yahweh Shay. Brakat Yahweh, Brakat Yahweh Shay. Bashem, Rakai Kodash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of great millstone who teach well and rule well, who taught me this truth. Peace and salutation to the Aki and the fellow laborers, the hopeful elect, pushing this truth at risk of their own lives through the four corners of the earth. To the awkward listening, listen and learning, Shalom. Your brother Shema from the Pillars of Benjamin camp. Here another lesson. And we'll get right into it. We have an article here. Identical articles, pretty much. One's dated today. Salakia, yesterday. May 4th, 2022. The year of Yahweh B'Shem Yashai turning up. And this one is from on The Guardian. This one is from April 28th, 2022. And this one is from Natural News. But they're pretty much the same. We'll read this one. Iowa factory culls over 5 million chickens after one bird illness case lays off 250 workers after burying dead birds. And you might have heard last week, I believe, during the Minnesota Timberwolves basketball game, there were protesters at courtside. They were protesting the way that these birds were culled, right? Workers at one of the world's largest egg factories spent nearly a month pulling the dead birds from their cages and dumping them in carts before they were piled in high nearby fields to be buried in huge pits. One morning in March, Rembrandt Enterprises workers were told to forget about their usual routine of collecting the eggs and feeding the birds because the factory started slaughtering over 5 million chickens when they detected a single case of the bird illness. Even their supervisors had to work on dragging the hens out of packed cages to be buried as a factory based in Rembrandt, Iowa, raced to contain the spread of the bird illness amidst what is now the largest bird illness. See that word right there, right? In the U.S., in 7 years, the culling also happened at chicken and turkey farms in 28 other states, with over 22 million birds killed in an attempt to contain the majority of it, however, is in Iowa, which is the biggest producer of eggs in the U.S. The slaughter of the 5.3 million hens at Rembrandt is the largest culling in the country. The company cut, you see that? 5.3 million, allegedly, right? Got to use the spirit of discernment. There's a lot of information coming out, you know? But all in all, we know it's all by design, right? And we know it's Yahweh B'Shem Yahshai putting the spirit on these Edomites, these elites, to forward their agenda. The slaughter of 5.3 million hens, right? The company culled the chickens using a ventilation shutdown plus, also known as VSD plus system, which closes off air to the barns while pumping in heat until temperatures rise above 140 degrees, essentially cooking the birds alive. Animal Outlook and animal rights group used the Freedom of Information laws to obtain records of experiments from the North Carolina State University that showed VSD plus causing extreme suffering to the hens as they writhe, grasp, pant, stagger, and even throw themselves against the walls of their confinement in a desperate attempt to escape. Right? A scripture came to mind when I read that paragraph. Proverbs 12 verse 10, and it reads, "A righteous man regardeth the life of his beast." Right? Righteous. The elect will regard the life of his beast. Right? The elect's not going to do nothing like that, man. The elect's not going to do. The elect's not going to burn alive chickens, hens. Right? But the tender mercies of the wicked are cruel. Who are the wicked? The Esau, Edom. The tender mercies of the wicked, even their tender mercies, what would seem as merciful, is cruel. right? Here it is. These Edomites are calling this a mercy killing, right? And it's cruel. Let's look at this in the NLT. Proverbs 12, verse 10 in the NLT. The godly care for their animals, but the wicked are always cruel, right? Esau, Edom, man. You know? And this is gonna usher in their grain of rice. Right? There's a lot going on, man. The famines and rumors of war, these are all things that are gonna usher in the grain of rice. They're gonna starve people. And present a solution. However, James Roth, an advisor to the federal government on biosecurity, said VSD Plus is the most efficient way of containing the spread of bird illness. Yeah, that's Esau, though, man. You know? Esau talks lies. You know what I mean? Over 250 cut off from work following the culling. After the culling and burying of the animals, Rembrandt Enterprises cut off about 250 employees, leaving only a few dozen people to staff the factory. Right, so they made you do your dirty work, and then fired you. Oscar Garcia, a former supervisor at the plant, said everybody was worried about the chickens, but while the bird illness does pose a real problem. It was inhumane the way the chickens were killed. And people who worked in those barns to pull out dead birds were working in terrible conditions during their 12 to 14 hour work days. They couldn't protest because then they'd be fired and lose their redundancy pay. Then they're thrown out of work and no one speaks for them, he said. However, after the chickens have been buried, workers were told to attend a meeting where they found a stack of yellow envelopes. That's like showing a knife to a chicken, you know? What's going to happen next? We worked ourselves out of a job, right? That's enough on that. But, Esau's making moves, right? And then they fire 250 other workers, man. You know? Let's get out James 5. James 5, verse 4, and it reads, "Behold, the hire of the laborers who have reaped on your fields," right? The hire of the laborers, the money, the pay of the laborers who have reaped on your fields, which is of you kept back by fraud, crieth. Right, that's what Esau does, keeps that payment, keeps that money. He did this in slavery to the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom. Worked them to the bone. And the slave didn't reap any benefits. Right? We see him doing this here. Worked his workers. And then cut them off, man. Right? "Which is of you kept back by fraud, crieth, and the cries of them which have reaped are entered into the Lord, into the ears of the Lord of Sabaoth." Right, the Lord of armies, Yahweh, right? He's talking about Israelites, okay? Right? Israelites have never had a fair shake in Esau's kingdom, right? Laborers who have reaped on your fields, which is of you kept back by fraud, right? That's Esau's MO, man. And he does it to his own people as well. You know, okay, you know, this is a mix. These 250 laid off is a mix. You know, but you know, there's a lot of Jake in there, man. Right? Job 30, verse 6, and it reads, "Ask ye now and see whether a man doth travail with child. Ask ye now and see whether a man doth travail with child," right? What does it mean to travail with child? Labor. Labor pains. birth contractions, right? Right? Have you seen a man go through labor pains, birthing pains, right? Wherefore do I see every man with his hands on his loins? And this is how bad it's going to get out here, man, right? Where men are going to have their hands on their loins. As a woman in travail, as a woman who's in labor, giving birth, and all faces are turned into paleness, right? That's how bad it's going to get out here. Faces turn into paleness, to paleness because of the fear. Right? This is a step-by-step systematic shutdown of things as we know it. Right? Famines are coming. Right? 5.3 million birds. That's the report going out. 5 million chickens. Right? They say roasted alive. Right? A time like no other is coming. Jeremiah 30 verse 7. Alas, for that day is great, so that none is like it. It is even the time of Jacob's trouble. Right? This is what's coming. A day that is great, so that none is like it. Right? Famines is coming. Death is coming. Gerger troops is coming. Sword is coming. FEMA camps is coming. Guillotines is coming. More pestilence is coming. Right? But he shall be saved out of it. Who? The elect. Beginning with the elect. The elect will be saved out of it on this side. Isaiah 19 verse 15. Neither shall there be any work for Egypt. Egypt. Spiritual Sodom. Right? No work. No jobs out here, man. It's going to steadily get worse. Which the head or tail of branch or rush may do. No work. In that day shall Egypt be like unto woman. Why? And it shall be afraid and fear because of the shaking of the hand of the Lord, Yahweh of hosts, which he shaketh over. Right, the Most High, Yahweh Shemuel Shai, is bringing the business, man. He's bringing the famine. He's bringing the plagues. He's bringing the love of many waxing cold. He's unleashing two-thirds on upper crust Edomites. Right, it's about to get wild out here, man. I was reading an article today. Earlier today. Let's see if we can pull it up. Right. Meanwhile, Sleepy Joe is pushing for $33 billion to be sent to the skirmish zone. Illinois spending millions to help homeowners with mortgage payments as foreclosures spike. That was yesterday. Foreclosures are up 182% in wake but high equity and high demand mean most of those at risk will sell, not lose homes entirely. Foreclosures surge 181%. And then today they raised the interest rate 50 basis points, 5 basis points. Interest rate hike. That was today. The Federal Reserve is turning to its most potent weapon. I think it was five, I can't remember how many of these, 0.5%, 5 basis points. The Federal Reserve lifts interest rates in double-sized hike, paving the way for much pricier mortgages, car loans, and other borrowing. Right, this place is through. And we just read where there's foreclosures. Right? This place is done, man. Right? The Most High is visiting this place. Isaiah 47, verse 10. For thou hast trusted in thy wickedness, right? Esau, Edom, America the Great, Babylon the Great. Thou hast said, none seeth me, right? You say, no one see me. Everything is done behind closed doors. Clandestine, secret measures, right? Backdoor deals. That wisdom and thy knowledge, it hath perverted thee, right? Your wisdom and your knowledge. You have a false sense of security, right? And thou hast said in thine heart, heart being mine, I am and none else beside me, right? You think you're going, you pushing forward with your agenda for the grain of rice. You think your NWO, you think purposefully collapsing. You think you're going to get away with this thing, right? The Most High have something for you. The Most High has you in a trick bag, man. Job 18, verse 5, and it reads, yeah, the light of the wicked shall be put out, and the spark of his fire shall not shine. Right? We know Esau prays to his left side entities. Right? It's going to be put out. The light shall be dark. The light shall be dark in his tabernacle, and his candles shall be put out with him. Right? It's going to come a time where he's going to be throwing up his incantations and his left side worship, and he's not going to get an answer, man. The steps of his strength shall be straightened. Straightened means a point of difficulty. And his own counsel shall cast him down. His own counsel shall cast him down. His allies. Right? Right? Verse 8, for he has cast into a net by his own feet, right? His own, he's going to walk into his own net, his traps that he set, he's going to walk right into it, his own feet. And he walketh upon a snare. I wanted to, ultimately, whatever it is, Esau's trying to push. It's not going to work. It's going to fail. What's that scripture? Psalm 73 and 18. No, that's not the one I'm looking for. I'm looking for, bear with me. This is a good one too, though. But I'm looking for, Psalm 73 and 18. Surely thou didst set them in slippery places. Thou cast them down into destruction. I think the one I'm looking for is Job 20. No, that's a good one too. Job 20:23, when he is about to fill his belly, the Most High shall cast the fear of his wrath upon him and shall rain it upon him while he's eating, right? So when this diabolical madman thinks he's about to close on his agenda, the Most High gonna close the door on him, rain it on him while he's eating. Rain what? Fire, nuclear missiles, ICBMs, thermonuclear heat. Here it is right here. Job 5 verse 12. He disappointed the devices of the crafty. The devices of the crafty. His grain of rice will be disappointed. Let's look in this word crafty. Subtle, shrewd. In the Hebrew.
Strong's H 6175. Arum. Arum. Second entry. Arum. Arum.
Khan, subtle, shrewd, crafty, sly. Right? And this is Esau, man. He's a subtle, crafty, sly, wicked, diabolical madman. Job 5 verse 12. He disappointed the devices of the crafty, right? The Most High disappoints the devices of the crafty, right? Esau's, all of Esau's devices will come to naught, so that their hands cannot perform their enterprise. So that their hands cannot perform the enterprise. Let's look at this word enterprise.
Strong's H 8454. Tushia. Tushia.
Right. Wisdom, sound knowledge, success. Sound or efficient wisdom. Abiding success. Right? So whatever it is he's trying to have success in, the Lord Yahweh Shem El Shai is going to make it come to naught. It's not going to work. Right? Success, because there's no wisdom in wickedness. Right? Let's get that. It's in us. Sirach. Sinner's counsel, prudence. Ecclesiastes 19 verse 22, and it reads, the knowledge of wickedness is not wisdom, neither at any time the counsel of sinners prudence. Right? All that left side shit. Right? It's going to come to naught. Stay prayed up. Pray without ceasing. Kwam Yashavala. Wa Abad. Babal. Shalom.